I went to Greenland with a team of people to study the impact of melting ice sheets on oceans and sea level rise.
The biggest uncertainty today is coming from what Antarctica is going to do in the next few decades and century, how it's going to respond to warm waters from the Southern Ocean getting in contact with the ice. Ice sheets and glaciers contribute to more than half of the sea level we've been observing over the past few decades, and if we want to be able to be prepared for what's going to happen with sea level rise, we have to be able to better predict how they will continue to change in the future. Water is not being distributed equally everywhere, and so because of changes in mass distribution around the planet and things like that, different regions experience different amount of sea level rise, and so this is becoming a topic that's not just scientific curiosity, but also has a strong societal impact because there are so many people and large amount of the population living near the coast where sea level is actually happening. That impacts people all around the planet. The largest uncertainty in future sea level projections comes from the Antarctic ice sheet. So if you want to better be prepared for what's going to happen, we need to have better improved projections of sea level evolution in the future and how the Greenland, Antarctic ice sheets and mountain glaciers will change in the future. Something I've noticed over the years is that people get more and more interested in the science and what we're doing. And these numbers that we put together are a big part of what reports like the IPCC, the Intergovernmental Panel for Climate Change, are using for providing a summary of the science and providing information for policymakers and everybody else outside of the scientific community so that they can be prepared and know what we should expect depending on different carbon emission scenarios and things like that.